Since buying the house, I've been dying to rip up this carpet in the master bedroom and lay down some solid hardwood flooring. So that's exactly what I'm going to be doing this week. Stay tuned if you want to see how it turns out.
Now, this video is sponsored by Lumber Liquidator. So I drove over to one of my local stores and sorted through their very impressive variety of species and designs, colors, and styles of flooring. If you have a flooring project on your to-do list, then be sure to check out Lumber Liquidators. There is a link for you down below. They're a great resource to get high-end brand names, but for lower cost. I personally decided to go with a 3/4-inch solid pine floor that is also pre-finished. The first thing you have to do whenever getting your flooring home is to take it out of the box and let it acclimate. I let mine sit in the living room, which is the adjoining room to the bedroom, for a full 7 days before getting started on my project. The master bedroom is around 430 square feet, so I brought home a total of 470 square feet of flooring material, which is what I thought I needed, plus 10%. To start prepping the room, I first went through and removed the baseboards. I used a flat bar and made sure to take my time to not tear them up. Next, I started removing the carpet, which is just held in place by those nasty little tack strips. You can easily just pull it up and then also cut the carpet into strips to make rolling it up a little bit easier. Or you can do like me and get impatient and try to roll up half of the room in one roll. But it is surprising just how heavy carpet is. Next up was removing the foam, which in my case was very easy because instead of being held down by staples, it was actually held down by adhesive on the outer edge. So in my case, this step took no time, but if yours is held in place by staples, then you will have to go through and remove every single one. After that, I moved on to removing the tack strips using a flat bar and a hammer. And of course, be careful because these little things are nasty. I used a floor scraper to scrape off the little bits of remaining foam that was on that adhesive. After giving the entire floor 3 thorough sweeps in a vacuum, I started laying my underlayment. I started on one side of the room, rolled it out, and used a staple gun to attach it to my subfloor. With all of the floor prepping done, I now started laying my flooring. Now in the room, there is a small section of tile that I did not want to remove. So I started my flooring off by ripping down a board that will act as a transitional strip between this tile and the hardwood floor. And you'll see that on this particular strip, I chose to cut off the tongue and only leave the groove. And I'll explain why I did that later on. To attach the board, I'm using a 16 gauge pneumatic nailer and I'm face nailing it. With that one in place, I can now start laying my rows. For the very first row, I chose to use the longest boards I could find in order to give this row a lot of strength. Now you don't want to start the row directly up against the wall. You want to leave yourself what's called an expansion gap. My baseboards are 1/2 inch thick, so therefore I left a 3/8 inch expansion gap, which will allow the flooring to expand and contract, but then the baseboards will cover up the gap whenever the room is finished. Since I personally have that tile to contend with, I figured out what I needed to rip down the first row to, so that whenever I get to the edge of that tile, the very next row will be able to be a continuous row from the far left wall to the far right wall. To set my first board in place, I measured 3/8 inch off of the wall, and then once again used my 16 gauge nailer to face nail it. Note that on my starter row, I have cut off the groove and have placed the tongue facing towards the room. When getting down to the very last board, I would take a measurement on what the board needed to be cut to and use my Triton project saw to cut the board to length. Starting on my second row was when I was able to start using full width board, which my boards are 5 1/8 inch wide. It was on my second row that I had enough room to start using a flooring nailer. Instead of purchasing a nailer, I rented mine at my local big box store. Since my flooring is 3/4 inch thick, I'm using 2 inch long cleats, which is the name of the fastener.
So with all of these tongues facing out and then having the tongue on the right, I made this transitional piece have the groove facing out, but then this transitional piece has the tongue sticking out so that whenever I put in this row, it has a tongue all the way down facing out for the next row to connect to. So if you have an outside corner or any situation, just make sure you're thinking ahead on how all the tongue and groove pieces will interlock.
If you're using tongue and groove board, then you're gonna wanna make sure that they're connecting to one another as best as possible so that you don't have any gaps. The majority of the time, I would simply tap the board in place using the mallet for the nailer. Now you wanna be careful because of course you don't wanna damage the tongue So the times that I would need to persuade the board a little bit more, I would use a rubber flooring accessory that has a lip on it that I could hook onto the edge of the board and then hit it into place a little bit harder. Something else to think about when you're laying down your boards is you want to stagger your seams. This not only gives the rows some strength, but it also gives the entire floor a very nice random looking look. What I personally would do was pick an assortment of boards from the larger pile in the living room and then bring them into the bedroom, making sure to grab boards from a variety of places in the pile so that I'm not grabbing all from one box. This also contributes to the random look in the end. Then from there, I would plan out my entire row of boards, making sure that I was happy with the overall look of the row before actually nailing anything into place. Total, this job took me a day to completely prep the floor, which included the baseboards, the carpet, foam, removing tack strips and such, and then 3 days to lay the hardwood flooring. A lot of that was me taking my time, figuring out what to do, making sure that everything was coming together nice and snug. But also, this was a lot of hard work, primarily on my lower back. So you might be able to speed up the process some, but if you're working alone and don't have a lot of experience, then I would plan anywhere from 3 to 5 days for the project. Sometimes I would run into the trouble using the longer boards that it would have a slight bow in it. To take out the bow, I would screw down a 2x scrap that I had in my scrap bin, then very carefully use a flat bar to pry in between the board and that 2x material. I would use my left hand to hold the board in place while using my right foot to hold the nailer in place, then use my right hand to trigger the nailer. Eventually, you're gonna get to the other side of the room where you're not gonna be able to use your nailer, and you're gonna have to go back to using a 16-gauge nailer. On the rows I could get away with it, instead of face nailing, I would instead shoot a nail diagonally into the tongue. Whenever you get to your very last row, you are gonna be on the hook for face nailing it. Along with renting the nailer and mallet, I also purchased the rubber flooring accessory you've seen me use, as well as this metal flooring accessory. And this tool is great for hooking onto the end of the boards. Also, something else from my experience, my room is not exactly square, and there was around 3/8 of an inch difference from one end of this wall to the other. And I compensated for that by using shorter pieces in this last row and ripping them down to slightly different widths. When it was time to move into the closet, I treated it very much like the initial starter row. I wanted a continuous row from the inside of the closet to outside in the main room. So I first figured out what I needed to rip down that very first board inside of the closet so that the second row would line up continuously with the board on the outside of the closet. After face nailing this board into place and making sure that second row was indeed gonna line up, then I continued the same exact process that I did outside of the room. And you can see here what I mean by continuous rows from outside of the room into the closet. Throughout the entire project, the very last board in any row, I would make sure to cut off the end of the board with the groove on it. But instead of scrapping this piece, I would then take it and use it as my very first board in the next row, making sure to place the cut edge up against the wall, which left the groove end exposed to accept the next piece. All right, let's talk about door jams. You can cut the flooring as best you can and just butt it up against the door jams. However, a different method is to undercut or to cut off the bottom of the door jamb so that the flooring could actually slide underneath it. I have a Japanese pull saw, so that's what I used in order to undercut the door jambs. And to keep my saw going in at a nice consistent angle, I would rest my saw on top of a scrap piece of flooring to act as a guide. And you can see that once the door jambs are undercut, then the flooring will be able to slide right underneath it. Getting to the very end of my room, I once again had to resort to face nailing the boards. And I'll warn you now that completing the last few pieces will probably take more time than nailing down 5 full rows. However, be patient because if you get to this point, you're almost done. And this is a good time to bring up that I chose 3/4 inch material so that it would come out flush with the existing floor that leads into the bathroom as well as the main room. So be sure to keep that in mind when picking out your flooring. After getting the transitional pieces down that goes into the bathroom, I then put in the last few transitional pieces that will go into the living room. And I must say, I am very pleased with how everything turned out. Big thank you to Lumber Liquidators for sponsoring this video. If you have a flooring project coming up and want to help support my channel, then please check out the link down below.
I love tackling any project that improves the home, but my absolute favorites are the ones that will drastically change the look or feel to a space. And that's exactly what a flooring project does. Now, while all of these steps involved are technically easy, it is still very much hard work. However, this is my very first flooring job, and I know that if I can do it, then so can you. But that is it for this one. I hope that you enjoyed it, and I'll see you next time. Wow.